you've seen and unseen. I tell you, I thank God for how the Lord has been so good and carried us through the heavy, heavy rain. Amen. And gave us wisdom on how to drive in the weather. Because if you see the way some people were driving, they were driving like it's a little hot day. Amen. No rain and a dry day. But I thank God for his, amen, keeping power. Amen. And how the Lord protected us and gave us traveling grace. And I thank God, amen, for everything that's been said and brought forth. And most of all, I thank God, amen, of that Sister Janet, when she says, love your families. Spend much time with your family as you can. You know, it just brought back remembrance when my mother got out of the car and my husband told her, says, well, I hope you enjoyed yourself. And you know what her words were? It's always nice to be with family. It's always nice to be with family. And we, as saints of God, are family. Amen. We might not be blood family, but we are family. And we need to stick together, to love one another, and to enjoy one another while we can. Amen. Bishop was saying, love one another. Enjoy one another while you can. Amen. Because there might come a day that you might not be able to do that. It might come a day. We know with the COVID-19, we have the safe distances. But baby, there might come a day when we're not even able to shake one another's hand, to even wave at one another. So we need to enjoy one another as while we have a chance. Amen. Praise God. I thank God because I was up at 4:30 yesterday morning trying to prepare, and I think we finally left after 7. And by the time everybody got dropped off and everything else, it was about 10:30 last night, amen, when we got home. So we went to bed. I didn't get to bed till about 11. But I thank God that the Lord gave me a mind to press my way to be in the house of the Lord, amen, one more time. And I just thank God for his goodness, his grace, and his mercifulness that the Lord has shown toward me. Amen. Today we want to talk a little bit about stronghold. Amen. The song said, oh Zion, what's the matter now? Amen. What's the matter now? Amen. Praise God. We're going to look on 2 Corinthians 10th chapter. And we're going to start on the 4th and the 5th verse. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imagination and everything that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of God. Amen. Praise God. And you know the devil is fighting, amen, us with strongholds. Amen. Praise God. He's fighting us, amen, with a stronghold. Amen. Praise God. And that can be the matter with Zion today, is the building up of strongholds. Amen. A stronghold is a defensive structure. Amen. A structure is an argument, a pretension that acts itself against the knowledge of God. Every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God. A stronghold is anything, amen, that exalts itself in our minds to be, pretend to be bigger or more powerful than our God. Amen, praise God. A stronghold, praise God, begins in our mind. Amen. And sometimes so much we have such a stronghold, it consumes all our energy and all our emotions.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. When we have a stronghold in our mind, whether it be forgiveness, anger, That stronghold starts in the mind.
Yes, Lord.
And if we don't pray and ask God to give me a mind that this stronghold be broken, amen, it's going to go to the heart.
Yes,
and when it gets in the heart, amen, praise God, we're going to begin to act upon it. Amen. God can break the strongholds in our mind. Amen. But we got to have a mind for this stronghold to be broken.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. We got to have a mind to ask God to help me. Amen. And when God breaks that stronghold, amen, you got to renew your mind every day.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes,
praise God. You got to pray because the devil is going to bring it back to you. Amen, praise God, whether it's forgiveness, amen, it's anger, amen, he's going to bring it back.
Yes, sir.
Amen, praise God, I can remember the times, praise God, you know, I'm going to tell you how a stronghold can work. I can remember the time, praise God, before my husband got saved, and I was still working, and I had to try to arrange my days off to be able to take him to his appointments. And one day, I wanted to go by Joann's because they had patterns on sale. Amen, for $1.99, and that was a deal. So I've gone taking him to his appointment, sat there and waited for him, and we are on the way back, and I'm stopping in Jensen Beach. And he goes, where are you going? I said, well, I want to go by Joann's to get a pattern. So we turn off, and he fussed all the way almost to US 1. Now, mind you, I've taken my day off to take him, but he didn't have enough patience for me to go to Joann's. I know he didn't like to go there. Had enough. And the scripture said, be slow to speak and slow to anger.
Yeah.
So when I got almost to US 1, I just made a U-turn and headed back to 95.
Uh-huh.
And I think it shocked him. Because he says, well, you going to get your pattern? You going to get your pattern? I said, no. No, because I was angry. Amen, but I was slow to speak. Sometimes when I get angry, you know, I kind of shut down. So I didn't want, because sometimes I know me, and sometimes when you're angry, all of us, I'm sure, sometimes when we are angry, we say things that we regret. So that's the devil's job.
Yeah.
So we have to be slow to speak.
Yeah.
So I turned around, and I headed back to 95, almost all the way home. You sure you don't want to get your pattern? You sure you don't want to go back? But you know, that was a stronghold, praise God, of me getting angry, but I said, no, that's okay. So I had to pray and pray, and Lord, help me to be slow to anger and slow to speak. See, and the devil will bring these things back to you. Somebody could have done something to you. And years and years ago, see, that devil wants to build up this stronghold. He wants to build a structure and a tall wall, amen, in your mind.
Yeah.
That this person don't mean me no right, and I'm going to get back at him. And I'm going to hold this thing in my heart. And do you know when you hold at you, building up a stronghold, amen, that you don't want torn down. But we have to pray.
Yes.
And ask God to tear down that stronghold.
Yes,
and when he tears it down, amen, don't think the devil ain't going to bring it back to you. Uh-huh. But he's going to bring it back. Uh-huh. And we have to pray and ask God, help me.
Help me,
Lord.
Yeah.
And sometimes a stronghold is hard to tear down.
Yeah.
And we can't do it by ourselves.
Oh.
Years ago, when I was a teenager, I had a cyst on my hand. And I want to tell you, when I went to the doctor for him to pull the fluid out, he had to pull and pull and pull because that stuff didn't want to come out. And he had to pull hard. Amen. Praise God. And he got it out. And that's where the stronghold is.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. It's hard to get rid of. And do you know what? Thought it was gone, but years ago, it came back. So the devil is going to approach you with whatever, amen, that stronghold that you have built. He's going to bring it back to you. Amen. But you have to pray, Lord, kill it from the root. Amen. Praise God. And I prayed and prayed and come back and I got prayer. And I said, Lord, you kill this thing from the root. Amen. Praise God. And God did it. Amen. But before, praise God, I would hit it, and it would cause me so much pain. And every time that pain was come, I would have to say, God rebuke you, Satan, in the name of Jesus, is dead from the root. And when God, when the devil bring that back to you, yeah, amen, you just have to rebuke him.
Yes,
don't just go alone, amen, and let it continue, build up in your mind. Don't dwell on it. Amen. Praise God. But ask God to help you.
Yes, Lord.
Ask him to lead you. Ask him to guide you.
Amen.
Amen. Through all truth and righteousness.
Lord.
Amen. The devil is going to work on your mind. Amen. Praise God. But we have to ask God for help.
Yep.
Amen.
Yep,
praise
Lord.
God. We can't kill the stronghold by ourselves.
Amen.
Amen. We need Jesus.
Yes,
amen.
Lord.
Praise God. And God gives us, amen, defense. Amen for it. Amen. The Lord will tell us in Ephesians 6 chapter, amen, that we have to put on the whole armor of God. The whole armor. Amen. He tells us how to dress. Amen. In the whole armor of God. And those are our defense mechanism, being dressed in the Lord. And then he also gives us something to fight with our offense. Amen. Is the word of God. When we can meditate on the word, amen, and be equipped with the word, amen, the devil got to flee. He's got to move, amen, but you as an individual have to be willing, amen, to want this broken.
Yes, Lord.
Sometimes people will hate you for no reason at all. They just don't like you because they don't like you.
Amen.
Amen. And I don't care what you do, you can't please them.
Can't please.
I don't care what you do. How you act, how you talk to them. Amen. They don't want to hear it.
Amen.
Amen. As our Sunday school lesson this morning, amen, the comment was made, sometimes people will have a wall built against you. Amen. The word can come. Amen. But we have to know how to bring the word forth, how to approach the person. Amen. But we have to let God do the leading. We have to let God teach us how to approach. And we have to ask God. Amen. Sometimes people have a strong hold, praise God, of talking a little too much.
Amen.
Amen. Too much. Amen. And you can't tell me this, you can't tell me that because I know it all. Amen. That's a stronghold,
yes,
of that tongue.
Yes.
Amen. And the Bible says, be slow to speak. Amen. Sometimes, praise God, there are things that we need to say, but we have to be led of the Lord. Amen. Don't let the stronghold overpower us. Amen. Praise God. But we have to pray. Amen. And sometimes when we have to talk to God, we have to remind him of these things. Lord, you told me to be slow to speak and slow to anger. So help me to be obedient to your word. Amen. Praise God. I want you to be encouraged today. Amen. And I want this stronghold in my life, amen, to be broken. Amen. And everybody in here today would say, Lord, let it start with me. Amen. Let the stronghold be broken. Amen. If I don't love like I used to love.
Amen.
If I don't talk like I used to talk. If I don't act like I used to act. Amen. If I don't do for others that I can do for. amen, that's in my power to do for. If I don't do it, that's a stronghold. And Lord, let it start with me today.
Yes, Lord.
Let it start with me, that this stronghold is broken.
Yes,
amen, praise God. And I feel, praise God, if everybody in here do that, praise God, Lord, let it start with me.
Yes,
amen, the temple will be full of God's glory. Amen, we can have, amen, others coming to the Lord. If we can say, Lord, let it start with me.
Yes,
amen, not you. Amen, I don't want to point the finger of you not doing and you not doing and you not doing. But Lord, help me to do what I can do. Amen, start in me.
Yes, Lord.
Amen, and do what I can do.
Amen.
Amen, praise God and pray. Amen, like I used to pray. Amen, the devil got a stronghold on the people of God. He don't want them to pray. He don't want them to come to the house of the Lord. Amen. The scripture says, forsake not assembling ourselves together. Amen. He got a stronghold. Amen. Praise God. And I think a lot of people, I'm not saying here, but a lot of people is using that for an excuse. Amen. We can't go to the house of the Lord. Amen. Praise God. But Lord, let it start with me today. We're going to make a commitment to the Lord that, Lord, start in me. Do a new work in me.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Help me. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
That you, what you would have me to do. Don't look at what others are not doing. But, Lord, help me to do what you would have me
yes,
to do.
Lord.
Pray my strength in the Lord.